I'm just going to show you the steps I go through while I'm editing high-end pictures. Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy, Oscar Ntege, again with yet another amazing video. I know it's been so long ever since I did a video for you guys. Yeah, let's dive into this. And now, let me just flatten this so that we take it from the very start. Now, the first thing I do is remove these very, very invisible pimples, okay? So that when I do the frequency separation and the skin retouching, I don't have to retouch, you know, to that extreme. So what are we going to do now? So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to just come here and I'm just going to create a new layer just up above the background layer, and I'll name this pimples. Why I do this is I remove the big pimples so that I don't over edit the picture when I'm doing frequency separation. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use this spot healing brush right here. Then I'll make sure you've sampled all layers. This one is ticked. Then you make sure it is a content aware there. Then we come and we begin just removing these, you know, these big pimples, you know, such, because this is the first panel beating. Instead of you just going into doing frequency separation right away, it's better off you remove these big pimples at this stage so that when you're doing frequency separation, you don't go overboard, okay? Then I'll also remove these lines here. Now get into the shades as well. So this is the basic panel beating actually I do. Then I'll just come here as well. Meanwhile, it's raining outside. I don't know whether the sound is clear. If it is clear, you just mention it's clear. Yeah. Just in the comment section. Just right there. Like that. So we have now done the basic panel beating. See, that's the before, that's the after, before and after. So the next thing we're going to do, we are now going to remove to match the skin color by removing blotches. Okay, so what am I going to do now? Now I'm just going to come and flatten these. I hate having many layers on top of the other. So I'm just going to come here and I press Control Shift and E to merge, just like that. Okay, if you're using a Mac, of course you press Command Shift and E in order for you to merge down. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm now going to do what they call blotching, rather removing blotches from the skin. You see, when you look at this image here, you see some parts are dark. This part is also darker than this particular one. And the neck is slightly still darker than the upper part of the face. So that is what we are going to match, okay? So what are we going to, how are we going to do that? We're going to do this using frequency separation. So I'll come here using the frequency separation action. I won't go through the frequency separation process because I have a full video, you know, just click the video up there in the card and you watch the video of frequency separation. And so now I'm just going to use the frequency separation action, which is this one. I'll just come and beauty frequency and then play it. So I'll just blur it out slightly like this. Just I get these not so much, just a little bit so that I see, I no longer see texture right there. Then I'll come and yeah, just say leave the rest as is and say okay. So I'll just come here into layers and I'll create just a layer slightly apart. Okay, this is now the tonal layer, the tones. So these are the textures just right there. So I'm just going to come here and create a new layer. So I'm just going to name this blotches. I don't know that that is even the right spelling, you know, but anyway, English is not my first language. So I'm just going to come here and get my brush tool just right there. And I'm going to come and reduce the flow to around 4. That is okay with me. Then I'm just going to make it bigger since the picture is big, and I'm going to remove all the hardness. So how do we do this? So I just pick a color. From here, I just press Alt on my keyboard and then I color pick, and then I come and just paint over this part, just like that. That is how I cover blotches. So it's still same applies here. Just come and pick a color that is close by and then I paint over the blotches, just like that, because it helps me to match, you know, all the skin colors. Now, when you look at also the neck, I still can't do the same thing. I'll pick a color most probably from this part here, and then I'll get my brush, still a soft round brush, and I'll come and just paint over like that. Like that. Because it helps me have at least skin tones that are, you know, that are matching. It really doesn't have to be very perfect. So if she had dark knuckles, I'll still do the same thing, you know, for the dark knuckles. But basically what I'm doing, I'm just matching the skin tone so that we have the skin tones all looking, you know, uniform. You don't want her to have black patches all over. So let me just zoom out just a little bit for you to see how it is. Look at this. That's the before, that's the after, before, after, before, after. Isn't that amazing? Okay, so now I'm going to flatten this again. Like, I don't want to have many layers on top of the other. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to press Ctrl Shift and E, or Command Shift and E if you're using a Mac, just like that, so that I match. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to come and now again play the frequency separation action, this one here, so that I begin now doing the actual skin retouching. So I'll come here and play right there. I'll come and still blur out this so that I lose that texture again. Not so much, just a little. I just want to make sure that texture is lost of that particular part. I don't want to take it overboard really, because I want the skin looking fine. So here I'll come and say, okay. And then I'll say, okay. Yeah, for those of you who are in the Retouching Secrets Masterclass, these are things that you know already. So this is the tonal tones, yeah. And we shall rename this texture just for your understanding, like that. Texture, okay. So I'm just going to come here and then get the lasso tool. I'll make sure the feather is at around 18. So I'm just going to come and zoom in right here. Then I begin, you know, smoothening the skin, not smoothening as such, but, you know, making the skin tones beautiful. So I'll come and blur it out here. I don't want to take it overboard to a level that she gets flat. So I still come and do the same thing over here. You still come here, and then I get into filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and then make sure you don't take it overboard, because when you take it overboard, it turns out to be flat, like many pictures I see on the internet. You don't want her to have flattened features. Still come right here. Actually, she has a fairly beautiful skin, yeah, that doesn't need a lot of post-production. Still, I come here and do the same. Now, this is a mistake, having the highlights burn out. Now, you don't want the highlights to burn out. I'll just come here and get still. Okay, sorry. Still, I'll just come here and still say blah. They say Gaussian blah. So I don't want the highlights to burn out. So I'll just come and, you know, create their own frequency just like that. Yeah. Because I want it to look, you know, beautiful, glamorously beautiful, but still without losing a touch of reality. I just want her to have a beautiful textured skin. Yeah. Still I come. So I just press Control F or Alt Command F if you're using newer versions of Photoshop. Now, this version of Photoshop I'm using is the Photoshop CC 2014. It's quite old. So I just press Control F to repeat a filter, just like it shows here. You know, you just press Control F in this. You can actually check here to see the shortcut you can use for your version of Photoshop, but it's all usually Alt, Control F, or Option, Command, and F to repeat an action if you're using very newer versions of Photoshop. So I'll still come here and just do the same. I'll come in the neck area. The reason as to why I told you it doesn't have to be really perfect is because this also helps to match the skin tones, yeah? This frequency separation. So I'll just come and then Gaussian blur, and then I would blur this out until I see that she is really amazing. Basically, this is a product short of sheds, basically. You may be wondering why it was intentional for me to leave these reflections in when I was shooting. It was very intentional. That's why actually you see these particular lines of the reflector. It was very intentional because having them translucent, people would only take their attention towards her face. And in order for me to show that we're advertising sheds, I had to give them this kind of hazy look to them. Yeah. Like that. I'll remove also all these. And yeah, that's that. So basically, we've worked on the skin of John. Now, if you want to see how I did the burning and dodging and all that stuff, I'll leave a video just up here so that you see how I burn and dodge the picture and give it more dimension. Meanwhile, if you want to master high-end retouching, you can join the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. Click the first link in the description below to join the thousands of photographers that are taking their photography to the next level using high-end retouching techniques. Okay, I'll see you in the next one, and adios.